Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And today on this video, we will be talking about the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man figures. Now, I know that there's the superposable and the other ones which are like somewhat okay, but we're not here to talk about those. We're here to talk about the spinning kick Tobey figure. And this one has like a spinning kick feature with the display, which I don't have it because I'm not willing to drop that much cash for it. But let's get into review.
Who goes there? Zap, whoa! With a wave of my finger and a flick of my dick, one zap from me will kill you quick, so get on your knees to suck and blow, but not right now, I've got to go!
Okay, so here we have the figure. The figure overall has a really good sculpt. It looks exactly like the movie, although on mine there is a few issues with it because I actually bought it off eBay, so it is kind of different. But from the side profile, you can tell it's really nice, and the back, I actually really like the back logo. And if you actually look at it closer, all that detail in the blue, it's like crazy. And Toy Biz always did their sculpts right. Like the head sculpt looks exactly just like the movie. And then, oh.
Oh my god, bro.
Oh, hell no, man. What the fuck, man? Get your ass on, bro.
Okay, so mine actually came in like that. I can't really do anything about it. I can't find a spare piece about it, so I just have to live with it.
Spider-Man, what the fuck? How did you get into my laboratory?
Don't worry, I'm helping you out here. Your brew's a little bitter.
Brew? No, those are my sperm samples. Get the fuck out.
He has none. But if you do have accessories from other figures, you could put it on this figure. Like this one that came with the McFarlane Joker. If you can hold it. I mean, you can put it on around his head or you can put it in his hands. Honestly, you have so many options if you have like so many accessories for Spider-Man related figures. Like this newsletter, like you can put it in his hand and like if you can. Go in. There you go. And then it looks good. It looks like he's going to work. Like that one scene of, I think it was Spider-Man 2, where he was trying to fly off with the pizza or swing away with the pizza. I mean, it looks cool. But like I was saying, if you have accessories, you can put it on him. Like this backpack that came with the Back to the Future NECA figure. It looks really good. And you have so many possibilities with this figure and his accessories. I mean, technically, one of his accessories was the stand with the train and Doc Ock arms, but like, I don't have that, sadly.
Joke's on you, Arlie. I identify as a woman.
So for articulation, his head can go all the way up at a very good range. You could probably push it back more. He can look down really good. He can look side to side, and his head does have like a neck joint, so it does allow him to look up more, looking up and looking at the side at the same time. I love that. His arm can go really far up, which is great. He has a bicep swivel, a great bicep swivel. And then he has double jointed elbows. His wrist can move, which is great. Only two of his fingers are movable. For his ab crunch, he can go this far down, and for his other ab crunch, he can actually go a little bit back, not as much, but still far back. His legs can kick up high, which is great. That's a really good kick. He has double jointed knees, and then he has a thigh swivel, and he has a boot cut actually. His toe articulation, which is great. And then he has a little bit of ankle pivot, only a little bit of it. But this one, you know, we can't really move it because it's kind of broken because I bought it like that. Also, I found out that on this one, it was supposed to have a knob in the back of the leg right here. Like it was supposed to have a knob. And when I bought mine, it looks like someone like ripped it out or took it out. Which I actually don't mind because if you actually look at the picture, it looks pretty bad. But you know, I'm not complaining. It looks better without it on its back. It kind of looks bothering. But other than that, the articulation for this figure is really, really good. And of course, it's not as good as the superposable Spider-Man, but overall, he has really, really good articulation.
He is a superhero and refuses to ever leave the house unmasked or without his eye makeup. Please welcome Batman.
My name's the Human Spider.
I don't care. Get out.
No, you got my name wrong.
Get out of here, you moron.
Here we got Electro, Sandman, Venom, and the Spider-Man 2 Doc Ock. Now, mine on the bottom are broken, and then the top are actually fine. I added a shirt for him like No Way Home. And here we got Toby and Andrew with the custom head sculpt. Now, the only thing that does bug me is that Toby looks kind of the same height as Andrew, but that's also because of the Andrew figure is not as high accurate. But all three of them look really good together. I can't wait for the newer ones.
I'm gonna put some dirt in your eye.
So for my final thoughts of this figure, it's a really good figure. Would I recommend it? It honestly, I don't know, because there's the newer ones that Hasbro's making, and then there's the newer one from SH Figure Arts, and I'm pretty sure Mafex can make them, and then Hot Toys is making one. So, I mean, at this point, I don't know if you would rather get the older ones from Toy Biz or the newer ones, because the newer ones look fantastic. Like, I'm not trying to take away any of the light for this figure, because this figure is amazing. Yes, it's kind of modified technically, because it doesn't have the mod on it, or the knob, but even if it did have the little knob, I still feel like this is a good Spidey figure because it's really poseable, it doesn't look terrible, it has great sculpt, great articulation, which is actually really important in my opinion. I don't know, it just depends up to you. I mean, if I had to recommend it, try to find it on eBay, but don't pay over 60 or over 50. It ain't worth that much, to be honest. I mean, it's just a spin and kick Spidey. I mean, I can't really move the other leg because it's stuck in a pose because it's a spin and kick and has a gimmick. But I mean, it sounds like I'm nitpicking, but I hope it's like, I'm not trying to nitpick. I'm just trying to say, like, yes, this figure is worth it, but at the same time, don't spend so much money on it. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe and comment in the video. And I also want to hear what you guys think of this figure. Have a good day. I'll see you guys later.
Raindrops keep falling on my head. And just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Raindrops are falling on my head. They keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun.